From the WLOE and WMYN News and Public Affairs Department, this is Community Accents, connecting Rockingham County people, businesses, and services, recorded live on location and broadcast Monday through Friday at 8:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. Video production funding provided by the Rockingham County Business and Technology Center. Entrepreneur-focused, technology-enabled, future-driven.
Good morning. My name is Nakia Hardy, and I'm Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum with Rockingham County Schools.
I'm Mary Doggett, the K-8 Math Lead Teacher.
I'm Alyssa Slayer, K-5 Lead Teacher.
I'm Tanisha Walden, K-12 Curriculum Facilitator.
We are so excited to be here with you this morning. We're going to be talking about some curriculum and instruction topics. Our overview today, we'll talk about the Common Core as well as the North Carolina Essential Standards. We're also going to talk about how that looks in elementary, middle, and high school. We're going to discuss the graduation project for our high school seniors, as well as our high school options academies that we launched this school year and the mobile learning initiative.
Dr. Hardy, could you please start by telling us a little bit about the Common Core and the North Carolina Essential Standards?
This is the first year of full implementation for the Common Core and the North Carolina Essential Standards. We have the Common Core state standards in English Language Arts and in Mathematics. So teachers have been implementing those standards K-12. We have the North Carolina Essential Standards in Science and Social Studies. Some of the key points in the English Language Arts standards across the spectrum, it really increases the complexity for students and what they need to be able to read and also what they must be able to do so that students are ready to meet the demands once they graduate high school, whether they're going to a college or university or they're going to a career. Through reading a diverse array of classic and contemporary literature that's very challenging, students are expected to build knowledge, gain insights, explore possibilities, and broaden their perspective. Also, the Common Core really has a focus as well on writing. Students should be able to write logical arguments, sound reasoning, and discuss evidence as a cornerstone in writing standards. We also want to make sure that students understand how to annotate and deconstruct text. This provides them with an example of really how to understand and dig deeper into informational pieces as well as literature pieces. In language, students are expected to grow their vocabularies through a mix of conversations, direct instruction, and reading. The standards will help students determine word meanings, appreciate the nuances of words, and steadily expand their repertoire of words and phrases. Vocabulary and conventions are treated in their own strand, which gives our teachers and students an opportunity to really make sure that they extend across the domain, including reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Some of the key points in mathematics in the Common Core: it really allows students in the elementary level, K-5, to build a solid foundation with whole numbers, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, fractions, and decimals. When you can help students build the foundation, it allows them to apply those concepts as they move throughout middle school and high school. The middle school standards are robust and provide a coherent and rich preparation for our high school mathematics standards. In high school, the high school standards call for students to practice applying mathematical ways of thinking to real world issues and challenges. We really want to make sure with our mathematics standards that students are able to apply those concepts to the real world, not just working math in isolation, but see how math is interconnected to the real world as well as other content areas. The high school math standards emphasize mathematical modeling, the use of mathematics and statistics to really review and analyze empirical situations, understand them better, and improve decisions. When making these mathematical models, technology is valuable for varying assumptions, exploring consequences, and comparing predictions with data. That's also very important. We're so excited about our high school mobile learning initiative, which allows our students to have access to their Chromebooks every day in their classrooms. So teachers have the wonderful opportunity to integrate that with math, science, social studies, as well as English. Alyssa, can you talk with us a little bit about the Common Core in elementary?
Well, the Common Core in elementary, we start out with the fundamentals, with foundations for reading. We had already started in Rockingham County using a systematic phonics program called Foundations. And so that matches extremely well with the Common Core and provides the students with a strong foundation for reading. In addition, Dr. Hardy's already mentioned that students are now looking at text more and engaging with that text and having direct instruction in how to analyze and explicate text. It's exciting to see children. I was in a fourth grade classroom working with children, and the children were able to look at things, notice certain points that the author was using, and discuss the text. And they were just carrying on the discussion themselves. And so it's exciting to see how they were truly digging into the text and excited about it. So we can see the Common Core is very rich with that because it's also integrated nonfiction as well as fiction. Of course, we always did nonfiction and fiction or informational text, but this way we're really looking at how we're balancing it and integrating our essential standards with the Common Core, which is the English language arts and the math. And so we're able to integrate those, and students are looking at their science standards or essential standards, and then that is integrated into language arts, and the same things with social studies as well. So it's really been a strong change. It's been a lot of work for the teachers. It's like first year teachers, really, but they're working as a team. They're dividing up the work, and they're growing. And you know, one of them said she was hesitant about the Common Core. She said, "But you know, I kind of really like this." So it's been a great experience for the teachers, kind of given some of them a little boost. But as with change, there are always growing pains with change, but it's going really well with our teachers in elementary. The math, now I need to talk about math too. Cannot forget our math lead teacher, just kill me for that. But talk about math. With math, lots of times we did, when I was in school, we did, you know, rote. We learned the formula, how to follow the rules. That's how I was, a little rule-oriented. But this way, when we're looking at math now, we're looking at it conceptually. So you really learn to understand the concept versus how to follow the rules, which don't always work, as Mrs. Doggett will always tell you, that they don't always work. And they may work on the elementary level, but once they get to middle school or high school, it falls apart. Those rules and tricks fall apart. So I feel like the students are really understanding more conceptually how to think about math, and it's more automatic, and their enthusiasm is greater as well.
Thank you so much. You know, one of the things that has been a challenge, as you mentioned, is this is the first year for implementation, and this is the first time that I can remember in our history of education that we have challenged our teachers across the state to implement all new content area standards and have high stakes assessments at the end of the year. And actually, during the month of May, we have been administering our end of course test, our end of grade test, as well as the measures of student learning. One of the things that we have tried to work hard in Rockingham County is to provide our teachers with professional development, as well as to try to make sure that our teachers have the resources that they need to implement the new standards. So we did last year work very hard with our teachers to provide instructional guides for all of the content areas. Those guides will be revised this summer and updated based upon what we have learned from teaching the Common Core and essential standards this year. And all of that kind of culminates at the beginning of our school year when we have our fourth annual educators conference. Alyssa, I do want to give you an opportunity. I know that we have had the opportunity this year to implement wireless generation and reading 3D in all of our elementary schools, as well as a little bit about the new legislation that I've heard about called Read to Achieve. Can you share some information about that for our families?
Yes. I'll start out with wireless generation, and we talked about foundations earlier, that's the basics, you know, basic foundation for reading, looking at phonics, looking at the sound awareness, how the students manipulate the sounds. And so the wireless generation has an assessment called Reading 3D, and it combines the phonics, or the dibbles is what they call it, with the actual oral reading of text and written comprehension and oral comprehension of text. It combines those measures, and it gives the teachers an idea of how they need to teach, what they need to do specifically with the students to move them along. For example, specifically with what's great about it is that with the phonics part, the students will complete a section. The teacher can look back and click on the score that the student has. They'll then find activities for that student that are very appropriate for the score. And the activities grow, and they show you, they get more difficult. So it really scaffolds the learning for the student and helps them progress to meet the next benchmark. And the students take benchmarks, and they're three times a year, beginning, middle, and end. And between those times, they're having formative assessments, which are ongoing assessments. And you may see the teacher with an iPad out, and she's assessing the students. In addition to the phonics part that I talked about, there is an oral reading and comprehension, which is written and oral comprehension part. Teachers are able to analyze the text there to look at the different cueing systems. That's what we call it within our when children are reading, they're developing different strategies. So they're looking at those strategies, and they're able to address those strategies in their guided reading groups. So this provides great feedback for teachers. It's wonderful for them to be able to, it provides us lessons. Not only does it tell us specifically what we need to do, but you have an entire collection of lessons. And North Carolina has created their own collection of lessons as well. So that is with the Reading 3D, the assessment there. And this is all part of the Excellent Public Schools Act, which came about in July of 2012. And next year, it is fully in effect, next school year. And what has happened with Read to Achieve, we want children to read, so we've had our assessment, which tells us what to do, giving us specific activities. So we want the students to be able to read by third grade. And so we have built all these, the foundation, we are using the foundations, we're using guided reading, we're using shared reading when we're reading grade level text, variety of strategies to balance our literacy block and integrate our science and social studies as well. But the students, once they meet third grade, they take the EOG. And if they pass the EOG, of course, they will go on to fourth grade. But if they do not pass the EOG, it will be readministered to them, or an alternative type test will be readministered. And if they pass that one, they go to fourth grade. If they do not, and they qualify for a good cause exemption, that would be someone who is an English language learner who has been in the United States only less than 2 years, or if they have exceptional child status or a variety of other things, they will qualify for a good cause exemption, and they will be promoted to the fourth grade. If they do not qualify for that, they'll be enrolled in a summer camp. It's a summer reading camp, and we'll have those across the county for the students. And they will be given an alternative test of reading, and they will have a portfolio which will be completed. And if that is proficient, they will go on to fourth grade. If it is not, they will be retained in third grade. Now, once they're retained, we're not just leaving them there. We are providing interventions. They will either be in a transition class, or else they will be in a class that will have pull-out intervention in that third grade class. And the pull-out will be very intensive, a systematic program for them to follow intensively with reading. And the 3-4 combination class will be where they're having some of the fourth grade curriculum still, but within that class, they're very intensively following reading. They have the opportunity for mid-year promotion, so it's not all or nothing. and if they're proficient, they get to go to fourth grade and finish up that curriculum. And of course, if they complete the EOG, they are going to fifth grade. If not, it is the principal's, obviously, that's always there. They're the final authority on all of this. If they do not, we're going to go back. You've had that mid-year assessment for those kids that did not pass third grade or who were retained in third grade. They did not pass that mid-year assessment. Well, they still have that retention label, on them. And they have a student portfolio, which is used to assess them. And they complete the fourth grade EOG. And again, the promotion is either you pass it or not pass it, and then the principal has the authority about their moving to fifth grade. So it's just a lot to remember. And you can see, you can Google Read to Achieve and North Carolina and find all this information. Very detailed.
WLOE Eden. WMYN Mandan. Listen online all the time. RockinghamCountyRadio.com. Video production funding provided by the Rockingham County Business and Technology Center. Entrepreneur focused, technology enabled, future driven. Visit our website for additional information, rockinghambusiness.org.
Thank you, Alyssa, so much for that update with the Excellent Public Schools Act and Read to Achieve. I also want to let some of our parents know that as students are coming home at the end of the year, there is a letter in all of our students' second grade report cards that goes over a brief overview of Read to Achieve and what they can expect. I also would like to thank our superintendent, Dr. Rodney Shotwell, as well as our director of elementary education in Title I, Ms. Tiffany Perkins, and our partnership with Scholastic. We are very excited that all of our second graders will be coming home with a summer reading pack, and we really want to make sure that parents and the students enjoy that summer reading pack. We think that's another way to help make sure that students really enjoy the summer, but also continue their love of reading. And that's going to help make sure that they are ready when they enter the third grade so that they can be successful in reading on grade level at the end of the third grade. If you have any questions about the Excellent Public Schools Act or Read to Achieve, I suggest that you contact your child's teacher, your child's principal, or please feel free to call my office. At this time, we're now going to transition from elementary to middle school. So I want to ask Mary to talk a little bit about middle school Common Core, middle school math, and what we're seeing now in our schools.
At the middle school, we're going to continue with the integration that Alyssa mentioned at the elementary level. If you think about the middle school, previously students saw math just in the math classroom, and you think of the real world, students are rarely going to be asked, quick, I need you to do a box and whisker plot. But they're going to be asked to develop a proposal, and in that proposal they're going to have to analyze some data and possibly create a box and whisker plot in that proposal. But also they're going to have to be able to communicate their thoughts in that proposal, and so they're going to have some excellent writing skills. So we really want the students to have that project-based learning going on in those classrooms. We want to see in the classrooms a lot of literacy going on. And so hopefully when we walk into our classrooms in the middle schools, we see project-based learning, a lot of writing, reading going on in all the classrooms, and we're taking baby steps. I believe this summer Ms. Walden is going to talk about a project-based learning, PBL, professional development starting this summer at the middle school, so that our middle school teachers get some more help with that, because it's not something that just starts. So that's what's going on in the middle schools, because we want our students fluent. We want them to know their multiplication tables. We want them to know all those skills that they've learned previously, but they need to be great problem solvers also, because that's what they're going to need to know in the real world. And they need to know how to communicate everything that they're doing in their heads, because now that we're a global community, they have to be able to talk about and share their ideas.
Thank you so much, Mary. And that really just reiterates, you know, our vision as a school district is empowering all students to compete globally. And we really have a commitment to the teaching and learning component of what happens with our students in our county and all of our schools every single day. As we implement the Common Core and Essential Standards, it's so important that students recognize that what they're learning is connected to a larger society and they can see those real-world applications, because we want to make sure that the kids in Rockingham County, when they graduate, are ready to compete globally, whether it means they go to a community college, to a four-year university, into the armed services, or directly into their career of choice. This is a great opportunity now, I think, for us to let Tanisha talk a little bit about professional development and how we're trying to make sure that our teachers are implementing the Common Core and Essential Standards and really prepared to provide students with these rigorous learning opportunities.
I think everyone at the table has alluded to or mentioned how this transition has impacted our teachers. It really is like being a first-year teacher again. So in preparation for this past school year, the 2012-2013 school year, we launched the school year with our Educators Conference, which featured several sessions throughout the day over 2 days that supported the North Carolina Essential Standards and the Common Core State Standards. We didn't stop there. It was important that our teachers had continued exposure to best practices and information to support their transition to the Common Core and Essential Standards throughout the school year. So at the elementary, middle, and high school level, we had collaboration sessions occurring after school. And that's where teachers were able to come together and share resources from their classroom, share information from professional development that they've gone on, and receive professional development from our instructional coaches and academic coaches across the district. And this really helped keep the pulse on what was going on in the classroom and what things we needed to stay at the forefront of our mind as we made this transition. I'm sure you got from Ms. Slater that the transition to Reading 3D and the Read to Achieve program has many components to it as well. And our elementary teachers have received systematic professional development on the implementation of Reading 3D throughout the school year. As we are beginning to close out this school year, we are excited to announce that today is actually our first day of registration for the Educators Conference that will launch our 2013-2014 school year. And once again, we will be providing the teachers in the district with the opportunity to self-select up to 3 sessions during our 1-day professional development that supports their needs in their classroom. Our sessions are directly aligned to the North Carolina Essential Standards and the Common Core State Standards. We really know that there's a lot going on, and we want to have as many opportunities for teachers to acquire the skills and feel comfortable about the new curriculum. So there are several professional development opportunities occurring during the summer months that teachers can opt to attend as well. We have Thinking Maps training, which is now aligned to the Common Core, which features some very clear and systematic ways for teachers to support critical thinking and writing in the classroom. Mary alluded to the STEM training, the PBL training that we'll be having this summer. We have a partnership with Wake Forest and their Center for Educational Research, Teaching, and Learning, and they'll be coming in and providing professional development for our middle school science and math teachers that supports problem-based learning, and will help provide them with experience of practicing this type of instruction and support them throughout the school year with their first implementation and getting comfortable with inquiry-based learning. We are extremely excited about the second year of our transition to the Common Core and the North Carolina Essential Standards, and we will systematically continue to provide opportunities for our teachers to receive adequate professional development and to increase their skills and knowledge. We're lucky here in Rockingham County to have such a broad base of phenomenal teachers who are really reaching out and searching to master their skills in the classroom and impact student learning across the district.
Thank you so much for that comprehensive update on professional development. We know that it is so important that just as our teachers are providing instruction to our students, that we as educational professionals are constantly learning as well. It's so important that we continue our professional development and growth for our teachers. And as Ms. Walden mentioned, you know, it really is a great opportunity to work in Rockingham County. When you look at what we're able to see across all 26 of our schools, you see high quality teachers really committed to providing engaging, interactive, and rigorous instruction for our children every single day. And the most exciting thing for me when I reflect on what we've been able to do with our educators conference is most of those sessions are facilitated by our own teachers. And it really speaks to our teachers being leaders, not only across our district, but across our state. We have several teachers that are able to present at the state conferences hosted by the North Carolina Department of Public Instruction or the specific content area leadership groups. And that speaks volumes because it says that the instruction that we are having in our district is second to none. And it's something that we should be very, very, very proud of. Tanisha, I do want to give you a little bit of opportunity. I know kind of time is wrapping up on us, but if you could talk just briefly about some of the things that we're seeing with Common Core and Essential Standards at the high school level.
I think it's important to really point out that our Common Core state standards and our essential standards are really focused on preparing students for college and career. And so we are really seeing a shift in increased critical thinking, evidence-based writing and research, and also much more emphasis on students being able to articulate, not only in written format, but in discussion, their arguments and what they're thinking. And as Mary mentioned earlier in the math, we don't see students being asked to do a, what was that thing, a whisker and plot?
Box and whisker.
Box and whisker. Okay. Math is not my strong suit. But we do see students being asked to make presentations and develop projects that incorporate math skills. And that's the same that we're seeing at the high school level and moving into college and career readiness. These standards really put students in the position to incorporate all their content area skills, all that literacy, all the academic content that they've learned, and see the connections so that they're able to articulate their ideas more fluently, that they're able to produce products, writing assignments, and presentations that reflect that knowledge, and they're able to problem solve situations. We're also really spending a lot of time in our classrooms making sure that students are acquiring 21st century skills, and that goes beyond knowledge of technology. That's really about how students collaborate, how students are using their creative skills, how students are critically processing and thinking through what they're being exposed to. So at every level, we are building a foundation for students to be successful in the workforce or if they choose to in a college environment.
Thank you all so much. This has just been a great opportunity. There are a couple of items we weren't able to get to. Please go to our website, www.rock.k12.nc.us. I would like to thank Ms. Walden, Ms. Slater, and Ms. Doggett for joining me. Have a great end of the school year and a great upcoming Memorial Weekend.